Here we go.
Okay, now since we caught the fish, now we're going to clean them. As you can see, I got a bullhead, a little bullhead, and a big old giant catfish. What I'm going to do is I'm setting up a place over here, Walmart bag, where I can put the guts in. First, I'm going to clean the little one here. I'm going to move this big guy out of the way. They have no teeth, so they really can't hurt you. I'm going to get me a new one of these things.
You could have been free.
Huh? Oh. Okay. Make sure you're sharp. Your knives are sharp. That always helps. Oh, she bit me.
Serves you right.
Okay. This is the way someone told me to do it one time. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
You start here at the back fin, and I'm going to slice it all the way up until underneath the front fin. Then I'm going to go straight down, and that's going to be the end of the head. Okay? You got to be very careful. I'm going to get the other knife. I like the other knife better. If your knives are not sharp, it's not going to work as good. Okay, I get it right in front of this fin, and then I'm going to take a start, go down. There, I just broke the backbone, and now I have the guts. Now I'm going to pretty much just slice the head off. There, the head's gone. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I got to gut it. I'm going to take the knife and basically stick it in its butthole and just slice up. Be careful you don't slice your finger. At this point, I'm just going to reach in and pull all the guts out and put them in my bag. And it's gutted. Make sure you get all the good guts out of there. It's gonna be bloody. Now I gotta skin it. All the blood gone. Okay. Once you get a good going good here, it should just come off easily. Like that. One side, now do the other. Still got me going?
Mm-hmm.
All right. These are nice sized bullheads. Now, I'm going to take the skin and put it in my bag. Now, some people leave these fins on, little fins on. I cut them off. I just chop them off. Some people leave the bottom fin on. I don't like the bottom fin. I chop it off. Again, be careful you don't slice your hand along with it. Some people like leaving the back fin on. I don't. I chop it off. Now, what I'm going to do is... Oops, there's another little fin there. Chop him off. I'm going to get right down in here. As you can see, there's a little bit of blood in there. Use my finger to kind of dig. Okay. I'm going to put that in water. Now it's my big boy. Okay. It's been a long time since I have cleaned one this big, to be perfectly honest. But it's a catfish, and what I'm going to do is do exactly the way I did the other one. Hopefully. Start here and go across here. Oh man, it's got a lot of meat on it. Go right here and then go down. And This one's going to take a little bit more muscle, I think. Gotta break it. There we go. Okay, bigger fish, gonna be a lot more blood. There we go. Wow. I'm gonna do the exact same thing. I'm gonna find the butt. Slice up. And just reach in and grab it. Ooh, man, this one smells. Okay, I'll be taking a shower after this one. Ooh, this one's got some smell to it. Are you getting a good there, Jessica?
Yep.
Man. Make sure I dig in there good. Okay. I gotta do the same thing. Skin it.
Okay.
This one's gonna take a little bit more muscle to it. Man, this guy's got some. I haven't caught one this big in a long time. You can hear my padre in the background. The reason I keep talking is because as long as he hears my voice, he does pretty good. Now I got a good grasp on her. In there, I'm just going to slice him off. Man, you got super glue in this guy, I swear. I'm gonna chop the fin off here too. See if I can't. A lot of good meat on this fish. There we go.
Okay,
there we go. I had to kind of let my dog come and join us. He feels better.
I'm gonna pause it. And we're back.
Left her there for a minute. Jessica had to go blow her nose. Man, this guy's a tough guy.
'Tis allergy season.
Yes, it is. Are you going to get your hands bloody? Yeah. But blood will wash off. You have to really clean this table off good. I weighed this. It was 4 pounds. So a 4 pound cat is pretty doggone good. I didn't know they had ones in there that were big. I'm gonna cut the fins off. Like I said, some people like them, some people don't. I'm gonna cut that off. That probably isn't good to have in there. Make sure I clean this out good of all the guts and blood and everything. Like I said, it's not the most pleasant smell. Ew. You smell it?
Yeah, a little bit. Probably because I'm standing farther away, I don't smell it as bad.
Yeah, I can really smell it. Really trying to get everything dug out of here. There you go. Okay. Okay, Jessica, why don't you go ahead and turn it off?
Okay, here we are.
Okay, go over here, on this side, over here. Yeah. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of, I want to clean it off here a little bit, okay? I want to kind of clean it off. Try to get as much of this inside blood gone as I can. I get as much of the chunk guts out as I can. Wash it off as best I can. Okay, this is what I want to do. This is a hunk of meat here, let me tell you. That's going to taste good. I got to get stuff in here out of here. This one's pretty good. I'm going to get the other one. That hurts. Well, this is nothing. Okay. There. Okay. Are you still filming?
Yep, we're filming.
Okay. Okay. What we're going to do now is we're going to go get a pan big enough to put those two in. And we're going to put some water in there with some salt. The salt will draw out the blood. Okay? You can turn it off.
Here we go.
Okay. Now we have a bowl of water and you put a whole bunch of salt in it. Okay? And you put your meat inside there. And what we're going to do is let it soak overnight. What the salt and the water will do will draw out the blood. Depending on how much blood you have, you may end up having to soak it twice. Okay? So we're going to turn it off now, and we're going to take it inside and put it in the refrigerator.
Ready.
Okay, now what we're going to do is we made a mess. Now we got to clean our tools. Okay, got to clean our tools good. You don't want to have any leftover guts or anything on there.
As we're cleaning them, want to explain what your tools are to?
Sure, thanks. I always heard these are called flat nose. I use them for peeling off the skin. And of course, these are flayers. And you gotta be careful because these are really sharp. So don't slice the finger when you clean it off. Always keep it, and I think they call these their scabbard. Down inside there, there's a sharpening tool. So every time you pull it out,
Sam, stop it.
This one has more of a saw blade to it, I noticed. So I use this one to kind of saw. Yeah, got a piece of guts on there that won't come off. There. There we go. Now what I've done, there. Oops, other way, dummy. There. Now I'm going to put those over there. What I've done is taken all my guts and stuff and I put them in here. This is the bag, and I rebagged it about 4 times to make sure it doesn't smell, and I'm going to put that in the garbage. Now what I'm going to do is clean off my table. If the dog's in the way, he's going to get wet.
Normally, you go down to a cleaning station. They have cleaning stations down by dams and stuff. But this one you can get at Menards for around like $35. But the cheaper, less expensive way to do it would be go to a cleaning station.
I agree. Clean off my hands here a little bit. Follow me to the trash can. Like I said, I got this bag like...
And you can use Walmart bags or any store bags, really.
Put it away, and that's about it. We'll come back on when we cook it. We're gonna give it a day or so to soak, and then we're going to cook it up, and we're all gonna try some and see how it is. See you then.